Hi, this is Kelly from Car Data Video, and we're going to show you the new Nissan Cube today. This is the press launch in Miami, and here we are on South Beach, and Marcus and myself will just give you a tour of the vehicle and give you an idea of what it's all about. The Cube is a very small crossover SUV, if you like. It's based on the Nissan Versa platform, and so it's a rectangular shape. It has a lot of interior space, and it's kind of quirky looking, but it's very functional. It's not terribly expensive. It runs quite inexpensively. It doesn't get the fuel economy of a hybrid, but it gets very good fuel economy. It's solid, it's comfortable, it's quiet, and Nissan's prepared to sell a whole bunch of these things. Interestingly, this is the third generation of the Cube. It's been in the world as a world car from Nissan for 10 years, but this is the first time we're actually getting it here, and we have the proper left-hand drive version of it. And so let's take a look at the Cube.
So Marcus, what do you think about the new Cube?
You know, I think it's good. I think it's definitely unique. I mean, we know that everybody's not going to gravitate to it initially, but I think that if you're looking for a unique urban vehicle, easy to move around the city, it's great space inside, very roomy, comfortable, has a live-in quality to it. It works. Great accessories that come with the vehicle. I think it should do well.
So it's not the kind of thing you'd be embarrassed to be seen in public in?
No, not at all. I think it would be kind of maybe odd for me at first, but I think that's what makes it cool, that it's odd. It's not like everything you see on the road. So it should do well.
So how about the shape? Looks like it's got a lot of room in there, does it?
Gang of room. I mean, this thing is, I'm 6'1", and 230, give or take a few, right?
I had only said 210, but you know.
But I think this, I mean, look, 6'1", great hair room.
Leg room?
Great leg room. Mm-hmm. I haven't been in the back. Let's see how it looks in the back. Well, you figure pretty good space in the rear.
You fit in here too, that's amazing.
So I mean, they've done well with the shape and really giving you the space that you would want in a vehicle like this. I mean, it's a lot bigger inside than it looks outside, which is great.
So how about the cargo area? There's still room back there with the space you got?
Space here, right? Fold the seats down.
So you can actually move these things out of the way. Velcro. Handy.
You know, the only thing I don't think I like about just particularly this interior, again, if you look at the fact that this is something that you're really gonna live in, I just don't know if I like this, the feel of this interior here. I don't know if this really says livable for longer than a month.
What's it, just too delicate or something?
Yeah, a little bit too delicate for me. I would like it I think more people would appreciate it if it was a little bit more durable. And then it could be just, you know, the light color as well.
Mm-hmm. So this seat slides forward and back too? It's right down there in the middle. Okay.
So you got
lots of room.
Gas mileage is not as impressive as I thought it would be at, you know, 30 miles per gallon, but.
So it's not a hybrid.
Yeah, it's not a hybrid, but I mean, 30 miles, we'll take it. Yeah. I mean, yeah. We'll take it for, what, 13 or 14 grand.
Yeah. So here we are in the Cube. Action shots now.
We are driving a little bit.
Yeah, Marcus at the wheel, and we're in South Beach. So I think this is an upgraded one. This isn't the base. I think this is a S or an SL. What's different about that is we've got a digital controls on the AC, And we've got an upgraded audio, and this has a Rockford Fosgate system, so there's a
Sirius sound system in it.
Aux in plug, and there's another cord here for your iPod, if you're an iPodder. And pretty good IP gauges, you can read quite easily. That's pretty decent. Actually, I like that position better than some of them that have center-mounted gauges. Floor-mounted shift, you can go to an armrest here on the driver's side. And tilt steering wheel, it doesn't telescope. And it's either available with a 6-speed manual or with Nissan CVT, which is kind of like a gearless automatic transmission.
You know, it's a solid ride, though.
It is?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it feels good.
Yeah.
It doesn't freak you out, you know?
A lot of small cars they're kind of bouncy and noisy, frenetic. Right. But this is, they describe it as serene ride, and I think that's actually a pretty good description. It's pretty quiet and serene here. Another thing they mentioned is, by the look, you would assume it's for younger buyers only, but they're smart enough in their marketing, and they've seen from other cars of a similar type that they get this bimodal distribution of buyers, and so there's this peak in the 20 to 26 age group, and then there's another one actually in the 45 to 55 age group.
Right.
And I can see that because they're not particularly concerned about style, but it's utility. So this is an inexpensive vehicle. Tends not break. It's useful. It's easy to get in and out of.
Right.
Runs cheap. Buys cheap. It's got good safety equipment. And I can see a lot of empty nester 50-year-olds who just would be happy to have one of these and just piddle around driving town and getting groceries or whatever. And I'm convinced that Nissan would be happy to sell them some. They don't have the same purism that Scion had about wanting to sell their vehicles just to a certain small demographic group,
right.
The younger bunch. So. Great, this is Kelly from Car Data Video.